The Coalition of United Political Parties, CUPP, says it has uncovered plots to scuttle the ongoing Electoral Act amendment at the National Assembly. This is as the coalition further alleged plans by the ruling All Progressive Congress, APC, to derail the 2023 general election by ensuring the electoral amendment process is not completed before the conduct of the 2023 general election. Addressing a news conference in Abuja, spokesperson of the coalition, Ugochinyere Ikenga, expressed worry that the general elections might not meet the expectations of Nigerians, as intelligence reports by the coalition suggest move by the lawmakers to ensure that the clamor for electronic transmission of results does not see the light of the day. He vowed that the coalition will mobilize Nigerians to resist the move, especially as it relates to attempts to rob the Independent National Electoral Commission its independence as guaranteed in the Constitution.
Electronic transmission of results will stand, and that position is immutable. Nigerians want it, INEC is ready for it, and has declared it has capacity for it. Yet APC wants to drain our democracy and subject the activities of INEC, a constitutional independent body, to the political whims and caprices of Nigerian Telecommunication Commission.
The CUPP further lamented over the state of the nation's economy, wondering why the APC-led government was not seeing the danger in borrowing when more than 98% of the country's revenue was already being used to service debts.
Nigeria's external loans have risen from 33% since 2015. Nigerians must know that for every 1,000 Naira Nigerians make today, 980 Naira is used for payment of debt. Which country can survive under such condition? What a shame. Nigeria now spends more on debt servicing than on health and education.
Ikenga also queried the deposition of the federal government to protection of lives and properties of Nigerian citizens.
The government is so confused and does not know what to do. These terrorists have advanced close even to the federal capital territory, Abuja, and are in firm control of almost all the entire local government areas in neighboring Niger State, and the government continues to gripe. All telecommunication signals have been cut off in the entire Zamfara State and almost all of Kaduna. This has made it practically impossible for communities under attack to call for any help whatsoever, leading to the clean of entire villages and communities, which are discovered long after the bandits have left.
The coalition says it is putting finishing touches on plans to declare Citizens' National Day of Action to protest against these perceived misgivings of the President Buhari's administration. CNN News.